Former Social Justice Minister Leonard Motute says government cannot throw its hands in the air and surrender to the current crime wave. He noted that there is a lot of talk about youth economy, but this must be converted from what he called a campaign bluff into measures to create youth employment opportunities. He also called on the government to provide the infrastructure so that more young persons can tap into gainful employment from international agencies by working from home. These measures, he says, will make inroads into the crime situation.
Working from home provides a golden opportunity where our St. Lucians, our young people in particular, can remain right here in St. Lucia and gain employment even from international external agencies and companies. Government, however, must provide the environment for that kind of undertaking to thrive. We must put the infrastructure in place, provide the training to our young people to ensure that they can take advantage of this new reality.
Many other opportunities, he added, exist, and not just in tourism, but also in the creative industries. Social safety net programs also came in for special attention, particularly the public assistance program to target marginalized households. But such households, he asserted, need not remain in that position. Measures should be in place to help such families recover and come off the public assistance list.
With the public assistance program, you may find a situation where a household is put under the social safety net program called PAP, public assistance program, because no one in the household is employed. But there may be young people who could be trained, who could be educated, who can develop skills, gain employment, and by so doing, the household will no longer have to be on the list for public assistance, and that is a burden that will be relieved from government.
Mr. Motute was speaking at Thursday's UWP press conference. For the DBS News World, I'm Don Nicholas.